Hello everybody, this is Angie and I'm here with another dollar idea. If you've never seen any of my other dollar idea videos before, I have two rules that I set for myself. Well, the first one is that the item that I work on or alter can only cost a dollar or less, no more. The other one is that I must use only the things that I have available in my craft room. I cannot go out and buy anything additional. And I found, been having these boxes from Michaels that everybody's been working on, especially the little square ones. And I have had this for quite some time. And I decided to do something very, very different for a child's birthday that's upcoming pretty, well, I would say in a few days. And instead of a birthday card, I decided to do something totally different. And I decided to do a treasure map. And the first thing I did, though, was to paint this wooden holder with paints I have in the craft room, and I do have this gold paint, and I covered it up pretty well with the gold paint. It has a little bit of brass in it too. I covered it inside and out, and it kind of shimmers and looks very, very pretty. And inside is the treasure map. So for the child's birthday, we'll go ahead and hand this to them. Actually him, and say, you need to have mommy help you with this because your birthday present is going to be found in here. And what it is a map, a pirate's map, on how he'll be able to find his gift, which is hidden in our house. So here it is. And I've used a lot of distress inks to try and make it look like a very worn, very dirty map that a pirate would have made on the quick. And the first thing you have to have with a pirate's map is a compass. And that was a dollar stamp that I used here. And then, of course, the pirates always want to warn any interlopers or people who might try to get their treasure. And that's a skull and crossbones from a punch that a friend gave me. And we have the beware here. And we needed to make it easy for a little boy to be able to find his present. So we just mapped out our living room. And we named it the Sea of Living Room. And I distressed it blue with my broken china distress inks to make it look like a sea. And then really just outlined an area. And they take a few steps, and we show them how many steps to take. Then go to the left towards aisle of sofa, and then go upward, and X marks where the treasure is. And there's the treasure chest right here, which is really just a chest that we have next to the sofa. And we're going to hide the gift in there. And there's Fireplace Island, and of course, to get with a pirate map, you have to have a smuggler's cove. And I'm not good at drawing, but I tried my best at it to put some little trees. And there's a pirate's cove where they can go later on to rest. And here's the kitchen island. And my very, very bad attempt at trying to make some kind of trees. I think I'm trying to make palm trees here. But anyway, that was my absolute best attempt at drawing. And I had a lot of fun doing it. It took me a little while to figure out how I wanted to do it, and especially make it a functional map for a child to be able to figure out where the gift is hidden, as well as be a little entertaining too. So that will go rolled up in here, as you saw, tied up. And tucked up in here. And later on, the child in our family will still be able to use this little case for some other goodies, or maybe even if mom wants to keep this as a memento of his birthday party. And I did have a lot of fun doing this. And if you want, you could do this for really anybody. It doesn't have to be a child. It could be an anniversary gift also. Hide away an anniversary gift for your loved one, Christmas, any other event. The other thing, too, is if you don't have this kind of box, You could still go ahead and make a treasure map, because this only took me one sheet of cardstock and just some distress inks, but I mean, as long as you can imagine it, you could figure out how to do it even if you don't have distress inks. But it was a lot of fun to do this, and it takes the place of a birthday card, and it will be a little memento of their birthday and how we hid the present in our house. So thank you for watching my video. I'm wishing you a wonderful creative day. Bye now.